Thank you. Good evening, everyone. Thank you all so much for coming to our concert tonight. I speak for all of us how special it is to have everyone here. For many of us, this is our very first concert live, playing and sharing our wonderful music with you all after the pandemic. So thank you very, very much for coming. It is a wonderful experience to be able to work with this group and to have all of you here supporting us today. I would like to invite Jean, our executive director, to say a few words. Thank you very much.
Welcome, everyone, and thank you again for coming. About a year ago, Joe and Michelle, our two co-directors, invited one of the singers to come and record a promo. Now, I've been in this business a long time, but I had never heard of this woman, and so I didn't know what to expect. But as soon as she began to sing, my first reaction was, "Dear one, where have you been?" And that speaks to the mission of the Open Gates Project. We want to open the gates and bring more of that extraordinary talent that's out there onto our early music stages. That way, you'll know where they are. We're joined in this work, by the way, by our national early music association, Early Music America. And I'd like to introduce their new executive director, who's in our audience, David. Would you stand up? David McCormick, there he is. So we're very pleased that on a national level, this mission will be realized as well. Now I'd like to introduce our co-director. Michelle Kennedy is in Oakland, California, and regrets she couldn't be here with us. She has a newborn baby. And I guess most babies are newborn, aren't they? A newborn daughter. And didn't want to travel with the COVID epidemic. But we do have the other co-director, Joe Chappelle, and I'd like to introduce Joe.
Well, first of all, hello and welcome. Welcome to the first concert of the Open Gates Project. Very exciting day for me, very emotional. For a long time, like Jean said, we worked on, this is basically our lockdown baby, is the Open Gates Project. Because we started this during the lockdown, and so most of this has been Zoom meetings and emails back and forth and talking to venues over the phone, you know. But to finally be here at this moment with you all, it's very special. I could say 1,000 things about this, but I'm gonna try to keep it short. One of the things that I often get from some of my friends when I tell them about this is, why do we need something like the Open Gates Project? Like, why does diversity and inclusion matter in early music? And my response to them always is, well, why wouldn't it be? They've done studies on, you know, over and over and over, and that show that organizations are always better when they are diverse and when they are inclusive. It's just a fact. You know, that the more diverse and the more inclusive anything is, it becomes better, because, you know, it's like you increase the gene pool of your organization by bringing in people with different perspectives and different views. So, you know, inclusion matters. And I believe that inclusion will be the salvation of things like early music, because you can't, I think it's impossible to survive if we limit this beautiful, amazing music to only certain zip codes and certain socioeconomic backgrounds. We need to bring everybody into this. You are looking at what happens when you have diverse people on the stage. Because when I was a little kid, someone who looked like me, I saw them playing violin, and that just opened up a whole new world to me. Because I saw someone who looked like my father and my uncles and my cousins doing this amazing thing, and I wanted to do it too. And I ran home and told my parents, "This is what I want to do." And I did not come from a musical family at all, but you know, God bless my parents. They were like, "Well, we don't know what this is, but okay, sure, we'll support you. Let's do it." And that began a whole lifetime of musical enjoyment and devotion to things like early music. I want to say two more things, and Gene is going to be really mad about one of them. The first is I want to thank my co-director, Michelle Kennedy, who's not here, like Gene said. She is in California with her new daughter. And that is a beautiful thing, you know. We're coming out of a period where we've experienced a lot of loss. You know, for Michelle and I personally, we experienced a lot of loss. We both lost a parent in the last year and a half. And, you know, this has been a time of like, just a really emotional time. And so for her to have a new baby now is this joyous event. And it's very coordinated with, you know, us together, we have our new baby, you know, the Open Gates Project, and that's also a beautiful thing. So I think she's in the room, even though she's not here. She's very much in the room because we do everything together, as you know, as far as Open Gates is concerned. We talk on the phone, you know, several times a week, and we come to, you know, unified decisions about everything. So this is as much her success as it is anyone's. So thank her. But the last thing I'll say, and I really need to say this, even though Gene is not going to be happy about this, is I want to thank Gene for making something like the Open Gates possible. I think it takes courage, and it takes foresight, and it takes commitment to do something like what Gene has done. It's, you know, he could have just started this and did it his way, but it was very important to him that it be done, you know, including the voices of the people he was trying to reach with this project. And he has given Michelle and I pretty much total artistic control over like the people we pick and the music that we choose, and it's been a joy to work with him. He is the executive director, but as Gene will tell you, GEMS is really an organization where everything is a team effort. You know, everyone has their title and their specialty, but really we do everything as a team. And it's been a joy to work with him. He has been a mentor to me and Michelle, just teaching us performers what it's like to do all the stuff that has to happen so that we can come onto the stage and perform. So I just want to publicly acknowledge him and thank him for allowing something like Open Gates to happen. Thank you, Gene.